In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Now the earth was formless and empty.
Darkness covered the surface of the watery depths.
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the surface of the waters. Then God said,
Let there be light.
And there was light.
God saw that light was good.
Then he separated the light from the darkness.
God called the light day.
And the darkness night.
Evening came, and then morning.
The first day.
All the earth is holy ground. All the earth is holy ground. Every single breath, every single sound, I can feel you with me now. I see your light. Where
they're sacred inside.
Creation implies God's authority over the world, and the Bible emphasizes God's authority over creation. God made us as part of creation, which leads to the idea of human stewardship of the creation, which is to be contrasted with the secular notion of human ownership of the world.
The fullness of your grace is here.
In other words, God entrusted us with His creation so that we may take care of it, not take ownership of it.
Creation affirms that human beings are made in the image of God.
In your presence, God, I'm completely satisfied.
Humanity possesses a relationship with the Creator, which is different from that of all other creatures. Augustine of Hippo said, "You made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they find their rest in you."
To show my love.
God was a community in Himself. He said, "Let us make man in our image." God desired to have a relationship with man, and after God saw what He had made, He said it was very good, for we are God's masterpiece.
Yeah, it's filling up the room. Yeah.
While God's creation is very beautiful, it's important to make a distinction between God and everything that He made. In Romans, Paul writes that there is a natural human tendency, as a result of sin, to serve created things rather than the Creator. It is important to distinguish God from creation, while also affirming that it is God's creation. Though the world is stained by sin, it remains the creation and possession of God, and it is to be valued for that reason, not worshipped.
Even though the world has fallen through sin, it remains God's good creation and is capable of being redeemed. God gives us free will to make choices for good or evil, and while He hopes that we will choose Him, it's not a forced relationship. 1 John 4 says God is love. Being made in the image of God means that when we show other people love, we're showing them the very nature of who God is. By earthly standards, it wouldn't make sense to sacrifice for the benefit of others. The desire to love and to be loved is only explained by the reflection of God in us and in His creation. So the heavens and the earth and everything in them were completed. God finished all the work that He had done, and on the seventh day He rested from His work. God blessed the seventh day and declared it holy, for on it He rested from His work of creation. From the tiniest ant to the biggest whale, God crafted everything perfectly in His eyes. And finally, He made man and woman to rule over the rest of creation, but more importantly, to have an intimate relationship with Him. God saw all that He had made, and it was very good.